Fishy, fishy, fish. Making it stinky.
What's up, guys? Welcome to another Robbie John tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to make some fish that essentially stay on the same plane if you want, or stay on the same axis. You can make it so that they go all over the place. It's up to you. But I made it so that the magnitude of the fish gets no greater than a certain amount so that they don't wander off too far. And then if they do, they just kind of like stay within the means of the magnitude, basically, if that makes sense. You know, like the distance between the middle and the where the fish are. So, yeah, this is what we're going to do. And hopefully you guys enjoy the video. What we're going to have first is, in this video, we're going to have a couple tweens. Basically, the first tween is going to be making the fish look where you want them to look. And so it kind of makes it so that it feels more real. They tween to like, oh, I want to go this direction. So they just turn and then they look that way. Making all the fish stay on the same up and down, basically. So like, if you make your, okay, right here, I have it, my y-axis set to 0. So if you look here on your screen, you can see that the y-axis is up and down. So the fish will stay on this plane here. So I'll show you that. If we just run it, you can see that they just kind of stay in the same level, right? They don't go up and down. They just stay there. They just go, they use the x and z axis. So the z is front, like this way and this way. So they'll stay inside this box pretty much. They won't go up and down, they'll stay right where they're at. And this kind of helps too, so if you want to stack certain fish and you want them down to the bottom, you don't want to have that weird, like, oh, they just tweened and ran into each other. You know, like, you don't have to, oh, it collides, like, oh, no, it looks bad because one fish is, like, deformed inside the other fish. So you could just use this as a, hey, we're just going to keep you on this level, essentially, and then you can make, like, stacks. So in this script, this is what you'll use for every fish if you want. You could break it down so that, you know, if you, this is just kind of like a, like, I guess a raw version of what I've made. You could edit this and make this even better for yourself. But we have the tween service in here. We have the fish. So in each fish, there's a script. If you want a game where there's a crap ton of fish, I recommend like, consolidating all of your scripts into one. Shouldn't be too hard to do, but I just figured on a time scale where people kind of want this, I just was pumping this out now. So we have the fish, then we have the center point. The center point is actually this big blue ocean that I have here. So if you click on this, this is what this is. So you can scale this as much as you want because the position doesn't change. As long as you're not moving it around like this, it should be okay. So we have the position. We're gonna get the position of the center point, so that's why I have that defined. Then we make the infos of how fast we want things to happen. So I basically wanted the fish looking at a certain speed and the fish moving at a certain speed. You can change these if you want. You can make them last a bit longer. You can make them, I made 0.7 seem like a good hotspot for making like kind of tween quickly to turn. And then 1.2 is actually pretty smooth, like slow speed. So I figured that was kind of nice, just for them to turn around or whatever. Then I made my max magnitude, and you guys can change this because the bigger the max magnitude is, the larger distance they can get from the center point here, and then they can expand outwards, right? So we have that, and then while we're doing this, you're gonna have a while true. What we're gonna do is, we actually don't need this. It doesn't matter, we can keep that in there. But I was gonna put this here, and you know, I actually have these two lines, but it's fine. So we're gonna have it determine the new position. We're gonna take our position where the fish is. Well, not our position, but the fish's position, right? And then you wanna get the, you wanna add the vector to it. So like, you wanna figure out where it's gonna go. It's based on where it's at. So you're gonna go through here, and you're gonna use, you can change this if you want. If you make it, essentially I'd use the same formula as this, but just change these two in here. Change the math that random in the inside. That way you'll have a percentage of 100 or whatever. It doesn't matter. It's up to you guys, whatever you want to do. But if you take away that 0.1, that multiply 0.1, they're going to greatly like move around, and you guys can test it out yourself. So if the center position, so we define the center point here, the center point position minus the new position's magnitude is less than the max magnitude, then they'll move. That's essentially how I have it set up. So if it's any greater than the magnitude, so if it's outside the box here, they won't move to that point, and it'll just cycle through to the new true, and it'll find its own thing again, right? So it'll keep cycling through until it finds a new magnitude. So then, what we do is we can take, we want to do the info look. So we tween the fish for the info look. This is this section here. And then we want to do the C frames look at. So we want to get the position that we're at, and then we want to look at where you're going to move. That's all that is, and you want to make sure you play. Bada boom, bada bing. We're going to wait that 1 to 1.2. I actually recommend making this just a 1.2 because then at least, you know what? I don't think it really matters, but all in all, I mean, it is a very short amount of time, but I would just make this the whatever your highest is. So I would just do like task.wait 1.2, so like this. Eh, I deleted too much. So just something like that. So whatever your max is for your info look at, that way you have time to do the full entire tween. Otherwise, it will just jump into the next tween. And what we'll do is this with this tween is we'll do the info move. So you can change these as much as you'd like. If you have like a very, very, very big area that you want the fish to swim around in, you can change the math randoms into something larger. This is the time here. So if it's, you know, let's say like you have like twice as much, you might want to do like 4 and 8 instead or something like that. Twice the size, right? And then you want to do the position. You want to get the position of your new spot, and that'll just tween the fish to the new spot, and you'll play that. And I always print this. You don't have to. You can delete this if you want, but this is just telling you, hey, this is the distance. So this is just telling you the distance between the fish and the center. So if you don't want a crap ton of stuff popping up, you can just easily do the double dash, and it'll get rid of it. It'll hide it. And then I wait 4 to 6 seconds, because roughly that's, I have 4, and then if you wanted it just to pause for a minute or two, or a second or two, that's how that works. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. It took me a little bit to make it, but it's pretty nice. Here's an example of when the fish actually like move up and down. We'll take this exact thing here and we'll put that in here instead. So now the fish will move up and down and you'll see them looking up and looking down and doing their little thing. I recommend if you're going to have them look up and down that greatly, I would say like I would change this like maybe to like half so that they're not just like sticking straight up in the air like, yo, what is up there, man? What is going on at the surface? So now they won't be like, you know, it'll look a little more natural, I think. You know, they're not gonna just like look straight up. Yeah, that looks so much nicer. So much nicer. But if you guys liked the video, please like, subscribe. I greatly appreciate it. I'll drop the script in my Discord like normal. If you guys need any help, please look out and look out below, man. Just jump in the Discord, ask questions. It's pretty simple. Didn't take me that long to make, but I know a lot of people want to make like an aquarium and stuff, and this is pretty simple to make and straightforward. So adios guys, have a good one. Take it easy. Love yous, take care, whatever, you know. Bye.